Hey, music's coming back to the Thomas Crane Public Library this month, and music professor Delvyn Case has stopped by to tell us about a four-part series that begins in January, runs right into February, from all aspects of rock and roll, Del.
Yeah, happy to be back.
Yeah, welcome to 2015.
Yeah, that's right.
What's going on?
Well, you know, I've given a lot of talks at the library in the past about all different kinds of music,
yep.
And the library approached me to do a four-part series on sort of the entire history of popular music in the rock and roll era.
Okay.
So we're
it's a big subject.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And I've taught this kind of course at various colleges, but it's been like, you know, 28 lectures or
okay.
something.
All right.
So it will be slightly compressed.
Yeah.
Actually, very much compressed. and you know, it's not. You don't have to be a musician to, I think, get a lot out of the presentations.
I'll
play a lot of recordings and discuss the songs. I mean, the thing about rock and roll is that, or popular music, is that everyone has their own experience with it. And I love hearing from people about the songs that were their favorites or the artists that they think are the best and why. So it should be pretty interactive.
All right, well, you start actually with the birth of rock and roll on January 27th. This is from 7 to 8:30. So you can talk about the kind of the coining of that phrase and how it all came about?
Yeah, I mean, what's interesting about the birth of rock and roll in the 50s is how so many different roots styles of music came together.
Mm.
Gospel, various kinds of blues, country and western, which at the time was called hillbilly music, various kinds of dance-based music, plus pop music.
Which the king was a gospel singer, right?
Right, exactly.
Yeah.
You know, so, you know, they all sort of came together at the same time in the mid-50s when you started to have this. The baby boomers had started to enter middle school. You start to have the transistor radio. You start to have the development of television, the idea of a youth market. And there was just suddenly this conflation of musical styles that sort of crossed over into the white teenage market. Suddenly the term was coined or rebranded by Alan Freed, the Cleveland DJ, right?
Yep.
And suddenly there's this new thing, and it changed the course of music history.
Huh, okay, it's very cool. Then you move on to the Rock in the 60s segment on February the 3rd, and this is kind of more where I can relate to in my era. Yeah, you get Stones, Beatles, the big supergroups.
Exactly, you know, because things really change with the British invasion from the Beatles, and then, of course, the Rolling Stones. And then you start to move into the psychedelic period with the Grateful Dead and the rebirth of the blues in the hands of someone like Eric Clapton and Jimmy Page and the Animals and Led Zeppelin, etc. So
electricity came into play, right?
Right, the electric guitar and all the different kinds of effects and distortion, etc. Really, the rock in the 60s is what the real basis is for rock music today. The 50s rock and roll is sort of very different.
Yeah.
You know, it's a different animal.
It's the Chuck Berry kind of, you know, persona as opposed to the Stones and the Dead.
Yeah, music was a lot faster. It was really meant for dancing exclusively, whereas rock in the 60s is more meant to be dance to, but also to be listened to.
Yeah.
Think of the Beatles' later music. I mean, you can't dance to a lot of the stuff that's on the White Album, you know, but it didn't matter at that point. But if you couldn't dance to at the sock hop where Chuck Berry was playing, you're going to go home.
Right.
So that really changed. Rock and roll really changed.
Huh.
Actually, it started to be called rock to distinguish it from rock and roll.
Interesting.
In the 60s.
Did culture change the music or vice versa, do you think?
Really complicated question.
I
think the link between the rock and roll era and the rock era is sort of the folk revival in the early 60s, where sort of rock and roll's original audience grows up a bit looks at music that's more serious.
Peter Paul Mary and Kingston Trio,
right. Okay. And then when Dylan plugs in, he connects folk music with rock music, and then you get the Birds, and everyone starts to do the folk rock thing, and then it becomes much more serious.
Okay. Then you're going to take us 40 Years of Rock on February the 10th, and we're talking about a whole different genre here. Yeah.
Well, what came out of the 60s is progressive rock, like Genesis or Yes or King Crimson, jazz rock, glam rock like Bowie, certainly heavy metal, which began with Black Sabbath or Led Zeppelin, depending upon who you believe, and goes up to today. And then punk in the 70s, and it's post-punk, indie, alternative rock, sort of everything since then, grunge, alternative. Basically, it has an electric guitar in it.
Exactly, yeah. we're going to wrap it up on the 17th. Taking it back to 65 and then bringing it to today?
Yeah, because you really have to look at soul music in the 60s as the progenitor for funk, which became the progenitor for disco and, of course, hip-hop, which is really, there's a clear connection between hip-hop today and the soul music of 50 years ago. So we're going to follow that trajectory. See what happened to black music in the 60s. Because, frankly, even though it's 2015, rock music, one of its definitions, if you were an alien and came down to to, you know, look on iTunes or go to a CD store, you'd think that rock music was popular music made by white people. Hmm. And you'd look at other kinds of music, rhythm and blues, and say it's made by black people.
Okay.
And the fact is that we are a post-racial society in some ways, but it's amazing how those categories are still so racially defined even today, you know? So it's, you know, it's very interesting. And this question of race is going to be go all the way through the four-part series.
Okay.
Because it's always in the forefront. The interchange between so-called black musical styles and white musical styles.
Interesting. So you'll be playing a lot of music, I'm assuming, right? And folks can just come out and listen and share their experiences?
Yeah, and you don't have to go to every lecture or
okay.
presentation. You can pop in on the one that you want to, and we'll pick it up from there.
All right, very good. Sounds like a lot of fun. It's Musical Notes, Rock and Roll History at the Thomas Crane Library, January 27th, February 3rd, 10th, and 17th. They're all from 7 to 8:30. They're all free, and you can learn about them at thomascranelibrary.org.